Hi everyone, this is Shali Bino and welcome to my channel. Measuring heights and distances is the most important application of trigonometry. In this chapter, we use trigonometry for finding the distance between the towers, buildings, height of the buildings, etc. So I have included five most important questions from the previous question paper. Hope you like it. So in this question, you can see that two pillars are there of equal height. So we have to draw two pillars of equal height and they are on either side of the road. Width of the road is 100 meter wide. Angle of elevation of the top of the pillar are 60 degree and 30 degree at a point on the road between the pillars. So that means we have to take a point such a way that from the point, if you look at the top of the pillars, the angle of elevation is 60 degree, and from here if you look at the top of the other pillar, the angle is 30 degree. So first we'll name this A, B, then this is C, D, and this point be P. So we'll write that. Let A, B and C, D be two equal pillars, and we'll take the height as h meter. So we'll write equal height pillars of height h meter each. Now let P be a point between AB and CD on the road such that PB equal to X. So we are taking this distance as X meter. So what will be the remaining distance? PD will be equal to 100 minus x meter. Now how will you find out this distance? So for that we have two right triangles and we'll make use of the trigonometric ratio. So if I take the first triangle, that is in triangle ABP, if I take tan 60 will be equal to opposite by adjacent. So here what is tan 60? It is root 3. So root 3 equal to h by x, or h equal to x root 3 meter. So we'll give this as equation number 1. In the same way, we can find the, take the other triangle also. In triangle CDP, there we have 30 degrees. So tan 30 equal to opposite by adjacent is 100 minus x, and tan 30 is 1 by root 3 equal to h by 100 minus x. And now what we can do is we can cross multiply this. So now the first equation is h equal to x root 3, and the second one we have to cross multiply. 1 by root 3 equal to h divided by 100 minus x. Cross multiply, we will get root 3h equal to 100 minus x. This is equation number 2. Now we'll substitute the value of h in equation number 2. Substitute 1 in 2. So root 3 into h, instead of h I can write x root 3 equal to 100 minus x. So when you multiply, you will get root 3 into root 3 is 3. 3x equal to 100 minus x. Take x term to the other side. So 3x plus x is equal to 100, or 4x equal to 100, and x will be equal to 100 by 4, and that is 25 meter. So we can say that the point is at a distance 25 meter from one pillar, and therefore from the other pillar it will be at 75 meter from the other pillar. So we write that the point is at a distance of 25 meter from one pillar and 100 minus 25, that is 75 meter from other pillar. So this is another important question which normally comes for the exam. Let's see how to solve this. A peacock is sitting on the top of a tree. Okay, so this is a tree and a peacock is sitting on the top. It observes a serpent on the ground. Okay, here the serpent is, and the peacock saw the serpent from the top of the tree. The peacock with the speed of 300 meter per minute catches the serpent in 12 seconds. Okay, it catches the serpent in 12 seconds. What is the height of the tree? So we will name it first A, B and C, and A, B is the height of the tree, that is taken as H meter. So let H meter be the height of the tree, and they have given the angle of depression. What is angle of depression? See, from the point A, this is the horizontal level and this is the line of sight. So the angle made between the horizontal level and line of sight is angle of depression, and this also will be 30 degree because they are alternate interior angles. Now which trigonometric ratios we have to select here? Here I'm going to take sine because we don't know what is adjacent side. BC, the distance is not there. So what I'm going to do is I will take sine 30. Sine 30 is opposite by hypotenuse. So AB by AC. AB is taken as H. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. Still we don't know what is AC. So let's see whether we can find out AC. So AC will be equal to 2H meters. Now they have given you the speed of the peacock and the time taken. So we know that the peacock catches the serpent in 12 seconds. 12 seconds. So we can find out the length of AC. AC equal to, AC is a distance, so speed into time. Speed is 300 meter per minute into time is 12 seconds. So we have to convert this minute into seconds. So 300 divided by 60, convert into second into 12. So when you cancel, you will get 60 meter. So AC is 60. And we know that AC is equal to 2H. So 2H equal to 60. So H will be equal to 60 by 2. And that is 30 meter. So we can write therefore height of the tree. Height of the tree is 30 meters. So this is also a repeatedly asked question. So let us try to solve the question. At a point A 20 meter above the level of water in a lake. So you draw lake. At a point A which is 20 meter above the lake, that means this much distance is 20 meter. The angle of elevation of a cloud is 30 degree. Angle of elevation means you have to look up. You're looking at the cloud. Okay. And this is the line of sight and this is the horizontal level. So this angle will be 30 degree. Now the angle of depression of the reflection of the cloud in the lake is at A is 60 degree. So if I give this as C, the reflection I have to give as, I will give as C dash. Now they say that from this point, you are looking at the reflection. So join these two points, and this point I am giving as C dash, and you can see that we are getting two right triangles. So I'm going to give this as P, this as Q, that intersection points. Okay, and then we have to find out the distance of the cloud from A. That is what we have to find out. Now, from where we will start? So we know that this distance is 20 meter. We don't know this height, so we can give this as X for the time being. And we have two right triangles, that's all we know. So how we can start with? So I'm going to take in triangle AQC, if I take tan 30, it will be opposite by adjacent. So tan 30 equal to opposite to CQ. CQ and the adjacent is AQ. So CQ we have taken as X and AQ you have to keep it as AQ only because we don't know the distance. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3 and that is equal to X by AQ. So what is AQ then? AQ will be X root 3. Now I'll tell you why we have chosen tan 30. See, in the next triangle that is AQC dash, there also I will take what? The angle as 60 degree, it is given as 60 degrees. So I will take tan 60. So I will get AQ as the common factor. So AQ will be there in that triangle also. So in triangle AQC dash, tan 60 is equal to opposite by adjacent. Opposite is QC dash and adjacent is AQ. See, here also we get one AQ. And what is tan 60? It is root 3 QC dash by AQ. Or we can say AQ equal to QC dash by root 3. So this AQ is equation 1 and this AQ is equation 2. Now we are going to equate the two. Now we have AQ equal to X root 3 as the first equation and the second equation is AQ is equal to QC dash by root 3. Now what is QC dash? So the figure is, this is the lake, this is the point A, which is at a 20 meter from the lake. Then you have the cloud here. Then when you join, then from the point A, you are looking down at the reflection at 60 degree. You're looking up at 30 degree. And this is P and this is Q. And this is C dash. Now what is QC dash? You know that QP is 20. And we know that the distance from the lake to the cloud is 20 plus X. So the reflection will also be at a distance of 20 plus X. So what is QC dash? It will be 20 plus X plus 20. So I will write that 20 plus X plus 20. That is QC dash divided by root 3. Now we can equate the two. So I will write here X root 3 equal to 20 plus 20 is 40 plus X divided by root 3. So when you multiply root 3 into root 3 is 3. So 3X equal to 40 plus X. So 3X minus X will be 40. 2X equal to 40. X equal to 20. Now what is the question? Find the distance of the cloud from A. That is what we have to find out. So we have to find out AC. This distance we have to find out AC. So if you want to find out AC, you just need the length of X. So which trigonometric ratio we can apply over here? We'll write sine 30 because sine 30 is opposite. Opposite is X divided by AC. So sine 30 is 1 by 2 and X is 20 divided by AC. So AC will be equal to 20 into 2, that is 40 meter. So we can write therefore the distance of the cloud from A is 40 meter. So the next question, from the top of a lighthouse, the angle of depression of two ships on the opposite side of it are observed to be alpha and beta. If the height of the lighthouse is h meters and the line joining the ship passes through the foot of the lighthouse, show that the distance between the ship is h into tan alpha plus tan beta divided by tan alpha tan beta m, that is meters. So we have a lighthouse, then two ships are there on either side, and they say that the line joining the ship passes through the foot of the line, that means you can join this. And then from the top of the lighthouse, two ships are observed at alpha and beta angle, that means if from the top you are looking down at one ship and this angle is alpha, so this is alpha, and you are looking at other ship which makes an angle beta with the horizontal, and therefore this is also beta, and the lighthouse is h meters, height of the lighthouse is h meters. So this is the figure, so I will name it A, B, C and D. So let's write, let AB be the, let AB equal to h meter is the height of the lighthouse, height of the lighthouse, and then CD is the, CD is the distance between the, is the distance between the two ships, distance between the two ships. Now the answer is in terms of tan, so we will take two triangles and take the tan ratio. So in triangle ABD, this one ABD, ABD, I can say tan beta equal to opposite by adjacent, opposite is AB and adjacent is BD, so I can write this as H by BD. Let it, this be equation number one. I'm going to take the second triangle. In triangle ABC, here we have alpha, so tan alpha equal to opposite by, so here also H by BC. Now no other values are given, so what we have to do is, what is DC actually, or CD? It is DB plus BC. So look at these two equations. Is there any possibility of getting BD and BC? We can find out from equation 1. Tan beta is H by BD. So what is BD? It is equal to H by tan beta. And from the second equation, tan alpha equal to H by BC. So what is BC? It is H by tan alpha. Now DC or CD equal to H by tan alpha plus H by tan beta. So H is a common factor, so inside the bracket we have 1 by tan alpha plus 1 by tan beta. Now if you take the LCM, it will be tan beta plus tan alpha divided by tan alpha tan beta. This is what we are supposed to find out. So therefore we write, therefore distance, therefore distance between the ships CD equal to H into tan alpha plus tan beta divided by tan alpha tan beta meters. So the fifth important question, from the top of a tower 60 meter high, angles of depression of the top and bottom of a vertical post are observed to be 30 degree and 60 degree. First of all, we understood that there is a tower and also a vertical post, that lamp post. So the tower is 60 meter high, and then you have a post, a lamp post. Let us join these two. Okay, they say that the angle of depression of the top and bottom of the vertical post are 30 and 60. So from here, you're looking at the top of the lamp post, and this angle is given as 30 degree. So you draw a perpendicular line from the top of the lamp post, and this angle will be 30 degree, alternate interior angles. Similarly, if you look at the bottom of the vertical post, that is 60 degree. So join this, and this angle will be 60 degree. So this is also 60. Now we'll name this. We'll name this as AB, this as CD, and this point we'll take as P. Now I'm going to take this as two triangles. So the first triangle I'm going to take is triangle APC. So I'm going to write here, in triangle APC, if I take tan 30 will be equal to opposite by adjacent. AP by adjacent is PC. So tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 equal to AP by PC. Equation number 1. Now I'm going to take the big triangle ABD, because already you know what is AB. So I'm going to make use of that. In triangle ABD, if I take tan 60 is equal to opposite. Opposite is AB. AB by hypotenuse. Sorry, adjacent BD. AB is 60. 60 by BD. Now look at this. BD and PC both will be the same, right? So I can write it as PC itself. And what is tan 60? It is root 3. So this is equal to 60 by PC. Or you can see this, you can write as equation number 2. So from the first equation, 1 by root 3 equal to AP by PC. And we can write PC equal to root 3 AP. Now what about the second equation? Second equation we are getting PC equal to 60 by root 3. So when you rationalize this, we will get 60 root 3 divided by 3. So we will get 20 root 3. So 20 root 3 meter. So PC equal to, that means the distance between the, I'll write here, therefore, horizontal distance between the tower and the lamppost is 20 root 3 meter. And next is height of the lamppost. So height of the lamppost is CD. So how will you find out the length of CD? CD equal to, from the total length AB, AB minus AP. So we already know what is PC, that is 20 root 3. So we can substitute in the first equation, and then we can find out what is AP. So AP equal to PC by root 3. AP equal to PC by root 3. So I will write here AP equal to PC by root 3. So 20 root 3 divided by root 3. So we will get 20 meter. So we'll substitute here. The height of the tower, that is 60 meter. So 60 minus 20 equal to 40 meter. So the CD is actually what? It is the height of the lamppost. Therefore, you write the height of the lamppost is 40 meter.